So as you can see, I'm listening to Ronnie's playback.
If any of you all are doing that in this business,
just
you're an amazing leader. You're working hard.
And I'm going to go ahead and end it here.
You're exciting. You're doing everything that you could possibly.
Even though it's probably longer, but this morning. Well, actually, from last night up until this morning, I just want to make sure that I'm still recording because sometimes I can't see the number, has been interesting, but it's been very rewarding. So, last night after they did the announcement, I was super excited because they doubled the points because I want to go on the cruise and I'm working very hard. My points are getting up there and I'm in a position where I can do it as well as all of you. So even if you don't have any points, if you get to work now, you can do it too. You never know what they might do. They might extend it. You never know, but start working now. But even with it, you know, I was happy about the people that got to go to Dash because it's a lot of people that have never been. I've gone one time before, but what dawned on me was, well, why haven't you gone again? And granted, they start doing it by top earners instead of title, which is okay, but it's like, well, Jennifer, why aren't you a top earner? And you know, I could sit here and try to blame it on my team, but it's not my team's fault by no means, because if I wanted to be a top earner, regardless of what my team did, I know what to do to make it happen. So yesterday God was just really telling me to rest and just, you know, don't do too much. And I pulled away from a lot of things that I would normally be working on. So I was like, okay, I'm just going to rest. And I just kind of chilled and kicked it. And then, you know, after the call, I went to bed. I went to bed extremely earlier than I ever did, but I was on instructions from God. So I went to sleep. And then I woke up and I still kind of felt uneasy. And I just was like, you know, God, I was like, you know, I believe everything that you said to me about my business. There's not a shadow of doubt that I know that this is where you want me to be and this is what you want me to do, because you've sustained me for almost 3 years. Next month is my 3-year anniversary. So I just need you to show me. I said to God, I was like, I just need you to show me what some fruit. I was like, you know, okay, I signed 5 distributors. That's great. I've been signing loyal customers. My business has taken a 360 since green carpet. That's great. But I just needed a little bit something else, because believe it or not, as positive as I can be, as motivating as I can be, as much as the love of God that is in me, the word of God and all of that, sometimes I too get a little bit like, God, where you at? I need you to show me something. But I just want to let you know how I work through that. So, even though I was feeling a little icky this morning, what I ended up doing was I started speaking over my day. And then I had to literally shift my entire mindset. I had to go work out. I had to get moving. I had to just kind of like rearrange my atmosphere because it was off. It was completely off. And I knew that I wasn't going to get anything accomplished with that kind of attitude. So, after I told God, I said, you know what, God? I submit my day to you. You know, whatever you want to do, let's do it. So I'm sitting in the bed and I start my posting like I normally do on social media in the morning. And I got a phone call. Girl, she was asking about a post that I posted last week, actually. And it was the skincare. And she was asking me some questions. And then when we got to the end of the conversation, she said, now, how can I go about getting this? These are the options I gave her. I said, we have a couple ways we can do this. You can order with me right now on the phone. I can actually put the order in on my computer. I have it in front of me. Or you can go online and I can walk you through it. She said, you know what? I'll just go ahead and order with you. So I'm surprised because this is like, it's happened to me before, but it doesn't happen often. She was like, you know, let's just go ahead and do it. So I put her information, everything went in. She got some skincare, loyal customer for the day, double points. So I'm extremely excited. I'm like, okay, God, thank you. Then I'm doing some more work. I'm following up people, doing my normal morning routine. And I get a text message. Hey, I want to know how I can make additional income from social media. Yada, yada. I saw your post, blah, 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 blah. This is all from Instagram again, guys. This is how powerful social media can be. So I'm like, okay, cool. She said something about, can you text me or talk? So I told her, I was like, well, if you can talk now. So we get on the phone. I explained to her the entire business and how it works. It's my first time talking to this girl from Canada. Okay, guys. She's like, so how do I move forward? And I was like, well, we can sign you up right here on the website with me right now, or you can log onto your computer and I can walk you through it. Another one. She lets me sign her up right there on the spot. So I say, and these are two people that first time conversations, it happened. So I say that one, if you're not closing people, you need to do some three-way calling. If you need to do it with me, let me know. I don't call myself a professional closer to be cocky. I call myself the professional closer because I close people and I want to help you. So stop doing it by yourself. Get with me, Tia, whoever you need to get with, and find out what you are doing wrong, okay? Oh, and also, you know, Ronnie's webinar that she's going to do, because she's the one that taught me how to be a professional closer by duplicating her, okay? Another thing, I said this to say, when you wake up in the morning or if you have a moment of discouragement, stop living in that place. Stop sulking in that place. Stop shutting everything off in that place. If you know you have stuff to do and you have to get up and do it, start changing your atmosphere, guys. Talk to God. Let him know, I'm discouraged about this. I need to see some fruit in this, God. I believe what you said, but I need to see it now. God honors when you're honest with him. Want to know how? I saw the fruit today. And afterward, I said, you know what, God? Thank you, because I believed you, but I'm so glad that you heard my cry and you showed me. So learn how to speak life into dead situations and learn how to operate outside of how you feel. Your emotions will kill you. Kill you. I could have shut my entire day down, y'all. Put my business phone and said, you know, I'm going to put this on silent. Oh, I thought I had sex. Put this on silent. I'm not in the mood. I'm feeling some kind of way. Went and did whatever. Went to the pool. Didn't care about my business. And I would have missed out on a distributor in Canada and a loyal customer, guys. All because of how I felt. Oh, something came up on Facebook. So, I want you guys to learn. Sorry, got distracted. I want you guys to learn how to change your atmosphere and how to walk in your success and how to believe God for the things that he says that he's going to do for your business, because he didn't lie to you. He didn't lie to you. And sometimes you are going to get discouraged, no matter how positive you can be, no matter how successful you may be, no matter how much money you make, discouragement comes. But you don't have to accept that. The only time discouragement and fear and all of those things can reign in your life is if you allow it to. You have the power to say, you know what? I'm coming out of agreement with this. This is not going to be my day. God, I need your help. And I know that this is going to turn around. And then you have to start taking those action steps to it. Okay? A lot. And I said this on a call earlier with Shay. God gives us the formula for what he wants us to have. He said he wants us to prosper. And he has a great plan for us. Okay? He says, without faith, it's impossible to please him. So we have to believe him for what he said. And that's that he wants us to prosper and to have all these amazing things and have this great life. Okay. But then he also says faith without works is dead. So if it's impossible to please him without faith, and faith without works is dead, that means you need to get to work. Believe God for what he said. Believe it in your heart. Come out of agreement with fear. And believe God for what he said that he's going to do, because I promise you, everybody's going to have those kind of days, but you got to remember what he said. You got to meditate on his word, and you have to have it so planted in you that you can shift your atmosphere and shift your outcome, because that's what I had to do today. As your leader, I felt some kind of way, and I was like, and that wasn't for me. I knew that. Recognize what it is that is for you and what's not for you. That wasn't how my day was supposed to manifest. Now, because I shifted my atmosphere and I moved on my faith and did some things actively, speaking things out of my mouth, declaring my day, praying and talking to God, having that conversation, getting out and going to exercise, getting my body going, and that's a whole nother video, my day shifted. And I want to talk about that too, guys. That's not what I'm talking about. I was on a Periscope. And if you're not on Periscope, get on Periscope, guys. It's the best for business people if you follow the right people. Some people on there doing God knows what. But for business people, there are some amazing people on there that you can follow. And if you're on there and you need to follow them, follow me and follow who I'm following. But she said there's a couple things that business people need to realize. And she says, don't let your want for perfection make you a procrastinator. She said, done beats perfection. So getting something done is better than it being perfect, because if it's done, you can go ahead and perfect it. So if you're not that great at posting on social media, you're not that good at talking to people, as long as you start getting some of these things done, you can perfect it later. If I would have tried to be a perfect distributor from the beginning, I would have failed. I fumbled over my words. I didn't know what to say. I probably even lied to a couple of people. But guess what? I got the call done. And some of those people signed. Some of them probably didn't. But guess what? I didn't wait to be perfect in order to get started. That's for you new people. Make sure that you go ahead and get started. Another thing, don't explain your dreams to everybody. That's the reality of business, period. Dreams, books, whatever it is you want to do. You can't tell everybody. Everybody does not have the capacity to hold and understand what it is that you have locked on the inside of you. She compared it to having a baby. People don't tell people they're pregnant until the first trimester is over. There's a reason for that, because they want to make sure that the baby is protected. Your dream is your baby. This business is your baby. Don't tell people who are doubters, and not saying don't show them, but don't tell them, oh, I plan to do this with this business and I'm gonna do this, because some people are going to look at you and say, girl, that business is not going to do that for you. It's never going to happen. Don't tell those people. Tell people who are dreamers and people that you know will support you. Another thing she said, if you're not making money, it's a hobby, not a business. Everybody that's watching this video, everybody on this team should be making money. If you're not making money, get with me. We need to talk. She said, be the change that you want to see in your bank account. Study your industry. Your clients should never know more about your industry than you. I'm not going to say anything else. That's good all by itself. She said, turn off your TV. Anybody who's close to me knows I barely watch TV as it is. I need to just call Time Warner Cable when I finish this video and tell them, cut my cable off, because I don't use it. If I spend that time reading, watching videos, watching Periscopes, there are people giving away free multi-million dollar business tips on Periscope, YouTube. Feed your brain something else than reality TV. Movies that aren't going to help you make any money. You're sitting there supporting somebody else's dream instead of building your own. Turn the TV off. Set a date that you want to be a millionaire. You have to speak some things into existence. And even like the Bible says, you have to write the vision and make it plain. I'm going to go put on my dream board when this is done the date that I expect to be a millionaire. Now, it may or may not happen. But guess what? If I don't put it out there, how is God going to come into agreement with what it is that I want? God said he'll give me the desires of my heart. So guess what? I'm going to let God know this is something that I want. And this is the date that I'm going to work, keyword work, to get to it. And then the last one she said, don't listen to anybody. Most people are scared of success. That's a big one. In this season of my life, I'm not even having conversations with certain people. And if I do, those certain people that I know I can't have those conversations with, I'm keeping them at a minimum. Doubters, people who lack faith, non-dreamers, procrastinators, get them out of your way. Ronnie says it all the time. I think she said it on the call too. You're surrounding yourself with people that don't believe in you. You're surrounding yourself with people that don't even believe in themselves. That's not the kind of company you want to keep. You want to surround yourself with movers, shakers, doers, innovators. You are a business person. You have a dream that's bigger than you. A dream inside of you that's bigger than you can ever imagine. Because once we finally go after what it is that God wants for us, he expands it. Okay? So don't talk to everybody about it. You have to be selective about who you share certain things with. Because that little sprinkle of doubt that they may put on there might drain your destiny. Believe it or not, it's so true. My business has taken a shift because I've stopped listening to people that I don't need to be listening to. Don't listen to people that make a lot of excuses. It'll rub off on you. Don't listen to people that aren't driven. It'll rub off on you. Don't listen to people who are full of doubt. It'll rub off on you. Seriously. So this video was a lot longer than I intended it to be, but I wanted to get that off my chest and to tell you guys, one, I'm just like y'all. I have my days, but this is how I get out of my days. And two, some of the things that I'm learning, because I'm learning so much information that's helping me, that I wanted to help y'all. So take whatever it is you need from this video, spit out what you don't need, and then implement it. And I hope that this video helped you guys. And Ronnie's doing a webinar tonight. She has not said the time, and I don't think she's posted it either. But as soon as she posts it, we're going to post it. I'm going to email blast it and get it out to everybody. We're going to post it in GroupMe. So be on the lookout for that. And it is to your best interest that you were on this call. You guys have a good day.